That's right, JR. I'm here with Susan, Brent, and Margot, their dog. They've dressed up for the parade with a bow, as you can see, to celebrate the Gamecocks. So they are here out celebrating our team and obviously dressing their dog up. So tell us a little bit about this costume, how you came up with it.
Well, this was actually my daughter's bow. My husband worked at USC, taught a while back, and she would go to the games, but she's outgrown the bow now. So it's Margot's bow, and we just opened a bar. Well, we bought the bar, The Aristocrat, downtown, and we thought we'd get her a t-shirt to kind of billboard for us. So celebrate the team and our new bar. Have a good time.
Yeah. Awesome. And you told me you had someone special visit your bar.
We did. We had Lamont Parrish visit last night another assistant coach. Not now, but
former assistant coach.
And we missed it because we went to Charleston yesterday with the family. But our general manager said they were in last night, The Aristocrat, and had a great time. So, sorry we missed it, but I'm glad to host them.
But glad to have them.
Yeah.
All right, wonderful. And tell us, you know, what are emotions? This parade's about to begin. How are you feeling?
It's many people here,
incredible.
And it's great to have community again. We went so long
with
everybody, and now we're just, you know, it feels like freedom, and this is just great timing, and it's wonderful.
Yeah. Great weather.
Everybody's
it's
in a great mood.
Fantastic.
So it's good to be out again. Celebrate the team.
Perfect. Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much.
Yeah.
And, you know, this parade, like we said, it's starting. It's about to start. So I'm going to send it back to you guys in studio. Reporting live from downtown Columbia, I'm Rachel Ripp.
All right, Rachel, thank you so much. We do have the list of entries here. We've got 65 entries in tonight's parade, anywhere from the Comet bus system to the Chamber of Commerce. I see some dignitaries along with the congressman there, the mayor.
Also, I don't see you anywhere, though. Where are you? Why aren't you in the...
Also, of course, the USC basketball players, and that's what everybody is here to see. As you can see, it's beginning to get underway now. But one member of the team, Reggie, is not going to be here. Destiny Henderson sending her regards, saying, have a good time out there tonight. She's a pro basketball player.
She is. Got picked 8th in the draft by the Indiana Fever. Of course, her last game, she scored 26 points against UConn in that national championship game. So what a way for her to go out.
All right. And again, that message from her just a few moments ago saying, sorry, guys, can't be here, but celebrate and have a good time. We also are going to have a program after the parade wraps up. That's going to take place out at the State House. We understand that this program is expected to last roughly 30 to 40 minutes, somewhere in that range. We'll bring that to you live as well. In case you're wondering, where's the parade? We're waiting for it to make its way down Main Street, Main and Laurel, as it will proceed down to the State House. All right, I believe we're going to be checking in now with Julia Kaufman. Let's check in with Julia, part of our team coverage.
Hey, JR, what's going on? I'm on Main and Hampton Street. I'm going to step out of the way because guess what? The parade is underway. People are already cheering. The parade is making its way down Main Street right now. We got some Gamecock flags, some excited music, signs, crowds are cheering. Look at these fancy cars we've got for the parade. Waves. Go Gamecocks, am I right? This is the moment people have been waiting for all day. Crowds have been lining the street. People whipped out their beach chairs, ready to watch this moment, and it's now started. The parade started about a block just ahead of where I've been set up all day. So we are catching the beginning of a very long parade, ready to go. This seems like a cool gang of cars. I want to jump into one of these cars. Earlier we spoke to some fans that have been staking out on Main Street, ready for this moment, and they said just how proud they are of Coach Dawn Staley and how excited they are for today. So let's hear from them.
As they've shown this year, they definitely did their thing, and I'm proud of them. I mean, I'm sure the city is proud of them. I mean, you see what we're trying to do for them and what they brought to the city. So, yeah, I'm definitely proud of them, especially with Dawn and everything she's just doing as a coach.
I think it is awesome as a mom to watch the parents in the crowd cheering on their kids, and especially like Aaliyah Boston's family coming in from the islands to watch her play. Like, it was just really cool. It's awesome to see women's sports take a lead.
With us on Main Street. This is just the very beginning. We have a lot more in store. As we said, the Gamecock women toss it back to you, JR.
Sandstorm playing in the background there.
Is that what that was?
I believe so. I think I do know that. If we can, let's talk about how they finished the season here as we look at that parade downtown Columbia. Gamecocks finished with how many wins?
35. Two losses. They lost to Missouri in the regular season, and they lost to Kentucky in the SEC Tournament Championship game. But as we mentioned earlier in the 5 o'clock show, there were really speed bumps, a chance to reset. And the NCAA Tournament's all about surviving and advancing. Well, the Gamecocks did more than that, and the way they played defense, it was the other team that was trying to survive, and obviously the way they dominated UConn. And there is Aaliyah Boston, native of of St. Thomas, the Virgin Islands, so her family will be here tonight. Again, the National Player of the Year. There you see Dawn and Cocky. This was at the Target Center up there in the Twin Cities area. And that's, you know what, that's when you win one, that's obviously special. But now Dawn's obviously in a different era, different level, if you will, by winning two.
And again, as this parade is underway, as it is taking place in downtown Columbia right now, we'll bring you more images in just a moment. The Gamecocks are the early odds-on favorite to repeat as national champions, right?
Well, you're only losing losing the one starter. You just saw Destiny Henderson, number three. You're losing her. Obviously, she's a big piece of the puzzle, but they've recruited so well. Dawn's had the top-rated recruiting class the last couple of years. You've got a lot of big-time talent on that bench. They'll be looking to step forward and fill that void. So, again, four starters coming back, yeah.
What you hear from a lot of players, though, Reg, is that they want to play for Dawn Staley. These players come from all across the country for a reason. They want to learn from Dawn Staley. That says a lot about the women's basketball program at USC, and obviously for Dawn Staley. She is probably the most recognized head coach, women's head coach in the country.
She was on with Trevor Noah last night. I mean, when's the last time that has happened? Mm-hmm. I don't recall that. You know, that says something where her brand is more than just about basketball, is more than just about Team USA basketball or the Olympics. You know, her brand reaches, you know, all avenues. And when you think about, you know, Dawn being a rock star, you know, she's able to track that talent. But even over in Lexington, where you had Olivia Thompson, the 5A player of the year coming out of Lexington High School, she could have played, you know, at a smaller school, but she came originally as a walk-on. I think she's on scholarship now. But obviously she wanted to be a part of a hometown team, a hometown feel, and obviously it's paid off. She gets her first national championship.
You know, for many years when you mentioned women's basketball in the United States, UConn came to mind, or Tennessee with Pat Summitt. But now, when you mention ladies basketball, women's basketball in the United States, South Carolina and the Gamecocks front and center.
They are. They are the team right now. They are the team to beat. They are the team that's currently obviously the reigning national champions. And there's no sign of this team slowing down. And looking at the national coverage leading into it, you know, the Gamecocks were the odds-on pick to win the national championship based on how they play defense. And obviously, they lived up to the billing.
Again, you are looking live at the parade that is underway in downtown Columbia. It started about 8 to 10 minutes ago. It is making its way from Main and Laurel Street all the way down to Gervais Street. There you go. How about that?
I'll pick out the sponsors that we see. That'll be my job.
I will tell you, they are entry number 20 out of 65 entries. So we're about a third of the way through.
From this vantage point right here.
As we mentioned, this is going to end at the State House, and there's going to be a program there. I know our sports reporter, Chandler Mack, he's there. He has been covering the team. He went to Minneapolis.
He went to Greensboro.
He went everywhere.
And he went to the Colonial Life Arena, too.
He went everywhere they went, and now he gets to be down there to soak all this up as we await the program's beginning, which should be in in the next half hour or so.
And I believe Richland County Sheriff's Department, I think we saw the blue flashing lights. They're obviously front and center. Leon Lott, a big supporter of Gamecock Athletics across the board. There they are.
We mentioned earlier Whitney Sullivan is downtown as well. Usually see her bright and early on News 19 this morning, but she is a part of the happy festivities down there. Whitney, what's going on your end?
JR and Reggie, y'all, it is so amazing down here. It's loud. There's lots of cheering, lots of honking, lots of music playing. It's everything that you expect when you're holding a parade for the USC women's basketball team, the national champs. Now, I want to give you guys some facts. I've been doing my research on the lineup. And so when you heard Julia earlier and there was Sandstorm in the background, kicking off the parade was Jack Haynes. He's actually a legendary Gamecock fan. And one of the things he is most known for is that Gamecock van. It is a 1964 Ford Echoline van, wrapped to rep represent South Carolina. And one way that you know he's around is if you hear Sandstorm playing. Now, some other people that we're seeing out here, we have a lineup of these really souped up, I don't even know the technical name for them, cars, but they look absolutely amazing. They've got music blasting. We've got fans dancing. But also what we're seeing is people getting up close. They're taking videos of people who are in the parade. They're interacting with them. It really is a good time. I don't think I've heard Sandstorm this loud ever before in my life, but everybody is blasting Sandstorm, waving their rags in the air. They've got their signs up, ready to go. And so they're slowly coming through, and I want to give you a vantage point of where I'm at. I'm actually toward the end of the parade route. The State House, I literally could walk there in less than 5 minutes. But again, check out these souped up vehicles. Also, what we're seeing coming down right now is the Comet. It brings mobility to the Midlands. As you know, they have dozens of bus routes, getting people from where they need to go, bringing people to games if they need to. But also what you're going to be seeing in this parade lineup as well are the Girl Scouts of the Midlands. And this is a really important organization in South Carolina, but specifically the tie that they have to the USC women's basketball team is they hold a Women of Distinction event every year to honor women who are leading and serving and impacting the community. And Dawn Staley was awarded not that long ago. Asia Wilson, I believe, was awarded back in 2020 or 2021, or yes, in 2020. She was also named an honoree, so they're a part of this parade as well. And so while you are going to see a lot of the players, you're also going to see a lot of organizations that are important to the city of Columbia and a lot of organizations that have helped the Gamecocks get to that national championship and help support them. But y'all, it is just an amazing sight to see. I can't believe I'm saying this as a Tiger fan, but it truly is incredible. A sea of garnet and black, and everybody is really just having a great time out here. Now, I'm going to stay out here. I'll keep you guys posted on what's happening. But JR and Reggie, I'll throw things back to you in the studio.
Good job out there, Whitney. Thank you so very much. You know what I'm missing out on, Reg? They're throwing candy. Some people are throwing candy to the
I'll take you to the BP.
I'm missing out. Kaylin Hagwood is downtown as well. What's going on from your vantage point, Kaylin?
Well, JR, I don't know if you can hear, but it is very loud between the cheers and the floats. Oh, my goodness. It has just revved up in energy in just the last 30 minutes. As Whitney said, a sea of garnet and black, hundreds, if not thousands of people just in this general area, all hoping to cheer on the Gamecocks. And I want you guys to meet Jeremy. These are actually the two Jeremys here. They both have the same name, and they come from Sumter. Now, you guys have been following the Gamecocks since the beginning, right?
That's right. We've been following them all the way through the championship.
So tell us a little bit about what made you want to just stick with the team. What makes you so passionate about the Gamecocks?
The coaching. I love the coaching, the atmosphere of the coaching, the staff, everything. I love it. The arena was lovely. The people, you know what I'm saying? The people of Columbia is nice. And the fans, I love the fam, you know what I'm saying?
So I know that they followed the team throughout their season, guys. They didn't get to make it to Minneapolis, but you guys were certainly watching. What did it mean to see the women beat UConn? And
Alina Boston done her thing, and Dawn Staley, a coach, a great team, and it just was a good moment to see South Carolina have another championship brung on.
So what are you looking most forward to at the parade today? What are you hoping to see? What are you hoping to hear?
I'm ready to see the players. Alina Boston, you know, she's number one, you know. And we're coming back, man. We're going to repeat. Trust me, we're going to go get it again.
I know they're chanting something that so many fans here are saying throughout this parade. Want to show you guys again what it's looking like. This is actually the start of the parade here at Main and Blanding. It actually starts on Laurel, just about a block down. But you can see as the parade just continues to come down, the fans, the kids, so excited as they're throwing out some candy, guys. Again, just peak excitement. Everyone hoping for another championship win for the Gamecocks. We certainly are as well, as this is a great victory for USC, a great victory for the state, and we're certainly all cheering them on.
Elin, thank you so very much. Hundreds, if not thousands of fans have made their way downtown.
I think you're looking at probably a few thousand fans, yeah, at least. And I think, you know, and the more, the bigger the vantage point. See, you know, if we get a nice wide, we see a nice wide shot right here.
Right.
But I mean, you're talking about, you know, you remember last time they had this parade was on a Sunday afternoon.
Right.
So shout out to the mayor for not doing it on a Sunday, because obviously I was busy. where you were as well. So yeah, we had a little golf tournament down in Augusta. But yeah, this is, you know, Wednesday night, perfect.
There's a nice vantage point right there, and you can see how many people have lined the streets of downtown Columbia. You know, this should not be a surprise to any of you watching, because if you've been to the women's basketball games this season, usually they're playing in front of a packed house. In fact, they've got the best attendance, I believe, of any women's basketball team collegiate-wise in the country. Correct?
It used to be Tennessee that would have, you know, that kind of crowd, you know, Thompson Bowling Arena, but now it's the Gamecocks that are selling out the Colonial Life Arena. And usually 12,000, 13,000 usually has been pretty much what they've hit for the most part. Sometimes you get a little bit higher depending on the high-profile opponent.
Is this contagious? I mean, when I talk about contagious, is this success contagious? Could this spill over into some other programs on the Gamecock campus?
Well, I think it's, it just, I think what it does is it just elevates everybody's game. Not that they shouldn't be already, but I mean, every coach, I don't care, you know, where it's the volleyball coach who's obviously had some great success, Tom Mendoza, give a shout out to him, you know, golf, tennis, you know, or the high profile sports. You know, these coaches are competitors, but when you see Dawn winning a national championship, there's a little bit of, you know, I think it adds a little something when you walk into the office the next day knowing that you've got a colleague who has achieved the highest status in their respective sport.
No pressure on Lamont Paris, a new men's coach.
Well, he's, you know, everybody just chill with Lamont. You know, I mean, the guy's he's got to get his own players in here, and he's obviously been building a staff, but I think Lamont will work out well. But, and obviously, you know what? You will not find a bigger basketball supporter of Dawn Staley than Lamont.
I believe he was at the championship game. I believe that is correct, in Minneapolis. Somebody else who was there, sports reporter Chandler Mack. He's outside the State House. Well, all of this is going to come to an end shortly, and they're going to have a big celebration there with lots of speeches, Chandler.
Yeah, JR, that's right. I followed this team while they were at Colonial Life Arena, and then when they went to Greensboro, and then when they ultimately won the national championship in Minneapolis. And one of the things that I saw was how the Gamecock fans traveled. And as you can see right behind me, they are so fired up to see their national champion, South Carolina Gamecocks. This is the second time that the Gamecocks have won a national championship. Second time that they're having this parade down Main Street, and so many fans are so fired up for this moment. In fact, these ladies right here, they have traveled with the team for years, since Dawn Staley arrived in 2009. Ladies, talk to me about just why did you guys decide to come out to the parade, and why are you so huge fans of the Gamecocks?
Because we just came to support the South Carolina women's basketball. Go Gamecocks!
For sure. And what are some of your favorite parts about this team? Obviously, there's Aaliyah Boston, the person who's won so many National Player of the Year awards. I'm saying so many. She's won all of the National Player of the Year awards, folks. So obviously, there's her. Destiny Henderson just got drafted. But what are some of your favorite things about this team?
They're the best. Okay, and that's what you say. They're the best.
Sure. And now just what? Yeah, and talk to me about that. I mean, Dawn Staley, when she arrived here, people thought none of this was possible. Now she has really changed the culture and has arguably made South Carolina, I'm a Gamecock grad, and she's arguably made South Carolina basketball school, now a women's basketball school. What can you say about Dawn Staley?
She the best coach. She win all her seasons. She the best. That's all you know you said. Go ahead.
She brought the women's basketball alive for the whole nation. And the women's basketball is number one in the nation.
In fact, the national championship game was the most streamed game, the most watched game on ESPN in almost 20 years, folks. So, I mean, that just shows the change of the culture that Dawn Staley has made. And you wanted to say something.
All I want to say is go!
Gamecocks! All right, with that, we're expecting the parade to continue. The parade is going to continue. I'm going to just go ahead and let these fans keep doing their thing, because they deserve it. It's national championship, and they deserve to embrace this team. And JR and Reggie, I'm going to go ahead and send things back to you guys in the studio.
All right, Chandler, thank you. From that vantage point,
it looks
right
bigger.
There, it looks like the crowd's growing
now.
Out
now
there.
we're getting to where you're getting to maybe the 12 or 13,000 fans that come to a game. Potentially probably have more than that on the streets, because obviously this is something that you don't see every day.
You know, that's a lot of people crowding the downtown area right now, all in honor of the USC women's basketball team. Our live team coverage is continuing in downtown Columbia. Nyjah Hood has been out there this afternoon. We're going to be checking in with her in just a moment. We have other team members down there as well, letting us know what's going on from their vantage point down there. This parade started about 20 minutes ago. We were told with 65 entries, they were expecting it to go about 40 to 45 minutes. And if that's the case, they've got about another 20, 25 minutes before they get the end of the parade gets to the State House.
And the podium, that's always a lot of fun, because you have a few players that'll get up there and again, you know, you get there in front of a live mic and you get to really kind of cut loose and really celebrate with the fans.
All right, as we mentioned, Nyjah Hood is part of our team coverage. She's along the parade route as well. Nyjah?
You guys, it is a beautiful day to be a Gamecock. The parade is in full swing. We've seen some gorgeous floats. Mayor Rickaman had just passed a couple moments ago. Columbia Police, Columbia City Council, Columbia Parks and Rec, all folks here on the ground to celebrate the women's basketball team at USC. I do want to introduce you guys to a couple super fans from USC. I have Miss Alma and Rosa. How are you guys feeling today to be Gamecocks fans?
We feel great.
What was your favorite part of the parade so far?
The cars!
Yeah, absolutely. So what brought you here today? And is it living up to your expectations?
Yes! Yes. You're proud of Gamecocks!
Yes! To support those mighty Gamecocks!
So if you guys are this excited now, how are you going to keep it up when the girls come out later?
Yes, we're going to keep it up. It's going to be now.
It's going to be worse!
For the road, did you just want to say a quick go Gamecock?
Go Gamecock!
Go Gamecock!
All right, there you have it, guys. Much more excitement to come later on the newscast. I'm going to send it back to you.
All right, and Reg, I believe we just saw Harris Pastides
I think we did.
In the middle of her live shot. We believe he's in a convertible, and he just rode by, right?
I'm sure he wasn't driving, but I think he rode by. And I think we see the Columbia Fire Department as well, and Solid Waste. COC Solid Waste, so yeah.
So what are you saying? Where are we here?
I think from that vantage point right there, we're at around 29 or 30. So this is the first half, if you will, of the entries.
What you have to understand is we have cameras up and down Main Street, so you may see one entry in the parade, and then 10 minutes later from another vantage point, you may see it again. So don't think that we've gone cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs here. That we just have those cameras up and down Main Street, so you may see some of the same entries repeat. All right, Rachel Ripp is in downtown Columbia as well. Let's find out what's going on in her location.
Hey, JR, it's hard to hear you a little bit here. We've got a fire truck, Columbia fire truck, paused right now in the middle of the parade. They've got their horns going on, and they are just excited for this U.S. women's basketball team, USC women's basketball team. I've also got some fans standing here near me, and this is Elizabeth, who I'm with, and she's a big USC Gamecocks fan. So, Elizabeth, tell me, you know, what are emotions like seeing this parade, seeing it all in action?
Oh my God, I am excited. I never thought I'd be here to see this day come. I'm excited.
Amazing. And so, tell me, do you have a favorite player on the team, or do you, you know, favorite coach or anything like that?
I love them all. I love them all. No special anybody. Love all of them.
Yeah. And so why did you come out today? Why was this something that was important to you and that you wanted to make time for?
Oh, I had to come out and support my home team. I wouldn't have taken anything other than just to be out here today.
Yeah. Absolutely. Awesome. Well, we've got all these sirens going on. It looks like there's a little bit of a pause in the parade right now, but I'm sure things will pick up here soon. All the lights flashing and fans cheering, just a lot of excitement in the air as we wait for our USC women's basketball team to come through in this parade. So for now, I'm going to send it back to you in the studio, reporting live from downtown Columbia, Rachel Ripp. News 19, WLTX.
All right, and Reggie, as things have paused on that end of the parade, things are still moving on this side of the parade. Perhaps a good time, not to take anything away from the basketball team, but perhaps a good time to mention there is a big scrimmage game coming up Saturday night at Williams-Brice Stadium for another Gamecock.
Well, that's part of the big Gamecock weekend they're talking about. It starts tomorrow night with the Gamecock baseball team taking on Ole Miss. You've got track and field, you've got beach volleyball, you've got tennis. But again, 7 p.m. Saturday night, as you mentioned, the spring game. First time that I can recall a spring game ever being played under the lights. They finished under the lights before, but it's the first time I can recall actually being played under the lights with a 7 p.m. kickoff. You've got a pregame concert with Patrick Davis, postgame fireworks. So it's going to be a lot of fun Saturday night at Williams-Brice.
Again, that's those fire trucks that we saw with Rachel just a moment. Looks like they are moving again. So the parade route is continuing to make its way down to the State House.
And I think it's probably because as you get closer to the State House, you know, you've got to divert that traffic somewhere, you know, because obviously you need to have room for the final floats, which features obviously the Gamecock women's basketball team. So I think that could have been where the pause was. It sort of looked, for a moment, it looked like I-26.
You know, when I saw the parade lineup last night, I'm like, wait, usually they have Santa at the end. In this case, Coach Staley, but it's Coach Staley and then the USC Police Department. So USC Police will bring up the rear this
okay.
year.
Well, but good bunch of law enforcement personnel over there. Good people over there.
Good people indeed. We hope to see the USC players momentarily. Their float should be coming up, and we'll be able to see them. Big Spur, Cocky is also still to come. Some former student athletes. Do you have any idea who those former student athletes are?
I think you'll find some former Gamecock women's basketball players as well, or it may not be limited to just that. It may be because I know DJ Swearinger has his alumni basketball game tomorrow night, mm-hmm. so we could see some former football players as well. Anybody, any former athletes who are part of Gamecock athletics at a high level, and who obviously love women's basketball, certainly I would think they would be there if they wanted to.
There is a certain former athlete who has a statue out front of the Colonial Life Arena, Asia Wilson. You believe she's here?
I don't know. I've not seen. By the way, her dad's birthday is today.
Yeah.
And she may be getting ready with. She may be out in Las Vegas with the Aces. Just don't know. But if she could be one of the former athletes.
Wait and see. All right, and some suited athletes as well. Whitney, let's go check back in with you from your vantage point. What's going on?
Hey, JR and Reggie. All right, so where I'm at, which is pretty close to the State House, I'm out on a patio, Palmetto Patio, and y'all, just passing me by was Congressman Clyburn. Also, we saw Columbia Mayor Daniel Rickenman. Both of them will be addressing the crowd at the State House for the ceremony that will be taking place there in just a little bit. Now, I can tell you, I have a rundown of all of the people who are in the parade, and the people that really are that you're really hoping to see, expecting to see, excited to see, which are members of the Gamecock basketball team. They are going to be coming in shortly. But right now, as you probably heard, we had a lot of law enforcement. We're seeing a lot of lawmakers, a lot of organizations that are really integral in making our city and Richland County just absolutely amazing. And so we have Columbia City Council right now passing me. And then you can see the South Carolina Gamecock bus, again, speaking to the fact that we are going to see the stars of this parade very, very soon. Now, I have to say, you know, I was speaking to a couple of people who are out here. I spoke to a young lady who's from Baltimore, and she said, I didn't expect this to be that big of a deal. I didn't realize this many people were going to be out for this parade. And I really think that speaks to the powerhouse program that Don Staley and the team has built. I mean, this support, the community support that the Gamecock women's basketball team receives really is an anomaly. And it just, again, speaks to the program that Coach Staley has built, but it also speaks to how important it is to ingratiate yourself into the community, like Chandler said earlier. But it's so beautiful because everybody who is out here, it's almost like they're a part of the team as well. You know, Coach Staley and the team calls Gamecock fans fams. She's really created a family atmosphere. And the best way that I can describe the aura, the atmosphere out here, it feels like a big family reunion, a big family cookout, because everybody just supports this team so much and so well. And so we're going to continue to stand out here and bring you updates. But I'm telling y'all, very soon, we're going to see the stars of the show. Back to you guys in the studio.
Stars right there. I believe we do. Is that Aaliyah?
Aaliyah Boston.
Yep, there you go. The National Player of the Year. There she is. And before that, we saw Dr. Harris Prestidis and his wife So there we go. The headliners have arrived. And look, and I saw somebody bringing a baby up for Leah Boston for a little picture action. Riding up to the State House in style.
And you hear the tremendous amount of applause for the players,
and
too.
The aforementioned Olivia Thompson out of Lexington High School, soaking it up. What a thrill for her, local product. She has a national championship on her resume.
And for folks at home, we are watching this just as you are watching this. We're seeing the parade unfold as you do at home in real time. And these players riding by to a lot of cheers, a lot of happy fans right now.
Absolutely. I mean, this is what they came to see. And obviously, they'll have more at the State House when they get up on the podium and speak to the crowd directly. But this is, it doesn't happen every day. We had 2017 was the last time we had a national championship parade for this program. So obviously, and it seems like the crowd's getting bigger.
Yeah, all right. So those were the student athletes, obviously, that were in those convertibles just a moment ago. Dawn Staley is not going to be far behind those student athletes.
She should be the next to the last car in the parade. Do we have any more vehicles, or is that? I think that may be it, because now everybody's starting to walk up, so that may be.
We got one more.
Let's see what we got. And I believe, given the reaction that we're seeing. Oh, there you go. There's the coach of the staff. It's the assistant coach, Lisa Boyer. And Jolette Law is also on the staff. I don't see Jolette, but I know she's out there. Fred Schmiel, Jolette from Wilson High School in Florence, former member of the Harlem Globetrotters. I covered her when I was back in Florence back a long time ago, so I've known Jolette for years. So good to see her with her national championship on her resume as well.
All right, so again, the players and the head coach in the convertibles making their way toward the State House right now. The parade has come to a temporary pause at the moment, I guess, as a lot of these entries are unloading and people are making their way to the State House grounds.
Yeah,
although, and I say this, make their way there. We've got a few more minutes to go because this parade is still going down Main Street. Dawn Staley and her players at the back end of the parade, they'll be making their way to the State House along with all the other entries.
And then, of course, again, we mentioned, you know, the fact that everybody will be at the podium, and it really is a chance to one final time, I guess, because we've had the celebration of the Colonial Life Arena where Dawn and Ray Tanner got to speak. But this will be a chance for everybody, really one final time, to sort of put a bow on the celebration. Right. I mean, obviously, you know, you're going to be celebrating for a while, but in terms of the official celebration, this will be the last words that they really speak to the crowd and kind of put a bow on what's been an exciting championship season.
Walker Lawson is in downtown Columbia. He continues our team coverage. Walker, where are you and what's going on there?
Well, guys, we are right near Blanding and Laurel Street where the parade started, and it has now ended, as you can see. If you want to take a look behind me, the street is almost completely empty now as the team and Staley went by. The crowds were louder, the chanting was louder, and they really came behind Staley's car and seemed to march right down the street with the team. It looks like everyone's pretty much clearing out here now, but fans, guys, it was an incredible moment. It just got so loud and so exciting. So now the parade is headed down to the State House. So not many people left here on this side of town, but guys, it was a great moment and everyone seems so proud of everyone here. Back to you guys.
All right, Walker, thank you. Obviously, Reggie, a lot of those fans who were down there at Walker's vantage point, they're going behind the parade and beside the parade, making their way to the State House for the festivities.
And that's obviously in the sea of humanity we'll see in front of them. We'll hopefully get a really good chance to get an, I don't know if they can track attendance for this thing, but I mean, I'm thinking now, you look at the big crowd, I mean, 17, 18?
It's a lot of people. 1,000. How does this compare to 2017 as far as the crowd is concerned?
You know what, I actually think, I was down there downtown a few years ago. I think it looks a little bit bigger, actually.
Yeah.
It looks a little bit bigger. And maybe winning two national championships, you know, I don't know. But we had, you know, if you remember that team, you know, you had some star power with Asia Wilson on that team, too. And obviously, so you had some, you had that kind of a draw as well. So, but here, you know, again, it looks bigger. And maybe, you know, Sunday afternoon then, Wednesday afternoon tonight, you know.
Who are some of the players coming back next season to try to win a back-to-back championship?
Well, you got Zaya Cook, who was outstanding. Mm-hmm. She was a first-team All-SEC or honorable mention All-SEC. So you have, obviously, you mentioned the aforementioned Aaliyah Boston. But then you have, you know, in terms of who else you have coming back, you have that highly touted recruiting class. And then you got Ashlyn Watkins out of Cardinal Newman High School, who signed with the Gamecocks. It was competed in the McDonald's All-American Dunk Contest. You have Talasia Cooper over at East Clarendon High School over in Turbeville. She's one of, you know, these two, you've got two five-star products from in the Midlands. East Clarendon, is it technically in the Midlands, or is it more of a PD type?
It's Clarendon County's
Midlands.
We'll claim them, sure.
So you have two Midlands products that have signed to make Dawn Staley's program even better.
I'm sure we have a lot of viewers in Turbyville watching right now.
Yes, and yeah. And as my mother told me a long time ago, don't speed through Turbyville.
That's some pretty good advice. All right, 6:35 coming up, 25 minutes away from the top of the hour as the parade makes its way in downtown Columbia. Rachel Ripp, we've checked in with her a few times. Let's find out what's going on with her right now. Rachel.
Hey, JR, that's right. We've got a lot of excitement, a lot of energy. We've got a truck coming past right now that's got some video on the side of it. And all these fans are cheering. They're waving their towels, waving their flags. People are recording on their phones this exciting, exciting moment for the USC women's basketball team. Now, we've got, I believe, the team coming up pretty soon here. I know we heard from some of our other reporters, and so we are waiting on some more USC Gamecocks to come through this lineup here. We've got a car coming through right now with the big national championship sticker on it for our women's basketball team. Lots of excitement, lots of music, lots of noise, lots of cheering. So a great energy for sure as this parade makes its way down to the State House. We've got some horns going on over here so we can see what's coming up next. Big horns coming through. So I'm just gonna let you guys take a look and listen. Some loud music as well, some lights. You can see over in the distance, people are waving their towels, they're cheering, waving their flags, supporting our Gamecock women here on their national championship title. All right, well, for now, I'm gonna send it back to you guys at the desk. We've got a little bit of a lull here in the parade, so more excitement continues. Reporting live from downtown Columbia, Rachel Ripp, News 19, WLTX. All
right, some technical issues at the end of her report there with her audio.
Well, we saw Jolette Law come through, so obviously the team is there, and they'll be rolling through in just a second.
And I'm not sure that we're going to do this on the fly here. I'm not sure if our producer can do this, but Destiny Henderson did put out a video earlier today. We heard it in the 5 o'clock hour, but for fans who are late tuning in, we hope to get that Destiny Henderson sound for you so you can hear her reasoning and hear her explanation as to why she is not part of the celebration today. Basically, she is a pro basketball player right now.
She's making money now for the WNBA. She's employed by the Indiana Fever, another one that has gone to the NBA. Obviously, you mentioned Asia Wilson, but we've had a lot of, you know, you've had Tiffany Mitchell who's gone up there as well. So it's, you know, Elena Coates out of Dutch Fork High School has gone to the WNBA. So a nice little list of former players that have gone to play pro ball.
All right, Ty Wong, he is in downtown Columbia as well, and he's near the end of that parade. Ty, good evening.
Yeah, good evening, Joe. I'm towards the end of the parade on Main and Gervais Street, and the energy is just as exciting as it is at the top of the parade. If you want to follow me over here, we're going to see all of these fans. They are so happy. All right, Joe, we're going to do one quick chant. As Rachel mentioned, we did just see our USC cheerleaders and our national champion USC dancers as well. And we're going to look over here. We do have some parade floats, and we're going to walk over here. We're actually going to try to talk to some of these people on the float if you want to come on and follow me. How are you guys feeling over here?
Oh, my God!
Let's go, Gamecocks! be a part of this parade.
It's amazing, dude. Look, it's amazing. It's look at the baby. People. Let's number one. Back. Number one. Let's go. Woo!
How are y'all feeling up here?
It's a one-of-a-kind experience.
You heard it right here, JR. One-of-a-kind experience for everyone. If you haven't been here to the parade ever since they last won their national championship in 2017, can I get one last Gamecocks over here? Yeah! All right, JR, we're going to toss it back over to you in the studio.
All right, Ty, he's having too much fun out there, isn't he?
He's having a lot of fun.
Whitney Sullivan is also standing by in downtown Columbia with more. Whitney?
So I'm near the end of the parade, y'all. This is absolutely incredible. We've got a DJ on the back of an 18-wheeler spinning, hitting the ones and twos right now. And of course, he is playing Sandstorm. I have to say that the music selection during this parade has been amazing. Now, as you can see, folks have been actually going up to the cars to shake hands with the players. Coming up right now next to me is Aaliyah Boston. And as you can see, folks trying to come up, say hey. I love that. But what's so beautiful is you can see the players are equally as excited to see the fans as the fans are to see them. It really is a beautiful moment. And earlier we saw not only organizations and lawmakers, but we also saw people who are critical to making the team a championship team. We saw coaches, support staff. We saw the practice squad, and they have an all-male practice squad. They're called the Highlighters. They were in the parade as well. But it's been so cool to see the players really having fun with the parade today. As you can see, they're waving, they're cheering, they're dancing, they're having a good time. Really great choice of cars here with all the convertibles, but you can see the fans going up, they're taking pictures, and again, the excitement is so great. Now, what I'm noticing, though, is a lot of people who were at the beginning of the parade, they are now making their way down to where we are, and it looks like a lot of them are headed to the State House, because as we know, once this parade ends, there's going to be a ceremony at the State House. We're going to hear from a number of speakers, including Coach Staley. We're going to hear from Congressman Clyburn. We're going to hear from USC's interim president, Harris Pastides. We'll also hear from the City of Columbia's mayor, Daniel Rickenman. But again, it's just a lot of good vibes out here, and fans are really happy to just have this time to connect with the players. And like you and were saying, JR and Reggie, how often is it that you get to experience in just a few short years two national championships? And I can tell, you know, the fans here don't take this for granted at all whatsoever. But again, it's just so beautiful to see the players embrace the fans the way that they have, and they really are family. But coming up on the tail end, is that Coach Staley? I think that is Coach Staley. It looks like she is signing autographs. She is taking pictures. Oh, she's coming in hot. Y'all see this vehicle? Okay, Coach Staley. I'm not surprised, though. You know she's going to ride in style. But there's a big crowd surrounding her car right now because everybody just wants to be able to get a picture with her and speak to her and shake her hand. And she's taking the time right now, as you can see, to sign those autographs. Of course, there is security around to make sure that everything is safe. But, you know, one of the great things about Coach Staley is not only has she built a powerhouse program, has really, really catapulted the USC women's basketball team to national spotlight, we cannot forget about the fact that Coach Staley is serious business on the court. I mean, she is one of the most decorated women's basketball players in U.S. history, and you can see her raising up some of who will become the next most decorated female basketball players in U.S. history. But she is capping off the parade here. As you can see, everybody crowding around, saying hi. But this parade now is going to end with things at the State House, a ceremony at the State House. But y'all, it is just electric out here. That is the best way to describe the atmosphere. But I'm going to go ahead and send things back to you in the studio, JR and Reggie.
Whitney, thank you so very much. No surprise here, Reg, that so many people want to take selfies, be in a photograph with Dawn Staley and these great basketball players.
And as engaging as she is, that I think that adds to it.
Yeah. Dawn Staley going to be around for a while to come here. She's not rebuilding, she's reloading, right?
Every year.
Yeah. All right, and again, we were told the parade would probably last roughly 45 minutes to get to the State House. And whoever did that estimate, they're pretty much right on the money because they're not too far.
No, they start a little bit late, I think. Yeah. They might start maybe a couple of minutes late.
Not that far
off. And given the traffic and the logistics of trying to move these vehicles, once you get to the State House and then kind of move them out of the way so everybody else can, the rest of the parade can come. That's a pretty solid effort by the City of Columbia.
We've seen a number of the student athletes, members of the basketball team, including Aaliyah Boston and other stars of the squad. You did not see Destiny Henderson, as we mentioned earlier in the broadcast. She is not with the team for this celebration. She is now a member of the WNBA Indiana Fever basketball team, but she did send a message to Gamecock fans late today. Take a listen.
Yo, hey, what's up, fams? It's Henny. Just want to say thank you guys for all your support and love. It's really been amazing, and I appreciate every single one of you. I know you guys are going to have fun at the parade tonight, so have fun for me. Thank you guys so much.
So that was her brief message to the Gamecock Nation as this parade is about ready to wrap up outside the State House.
And you know, the team is more than just Aaliyah Boston. And I mean, you have Destiny Henderson, you have Zaya Cook, you have Victoria Saxton, who's coming back for a fifth year because she wants to enhance her game and obviously play for another national championship. So there's a lot of solid pieces and a lot of these players that come off the bench, they could start, obviously, for a lot of programs, and here they are.
I don't really like talking about what-ifs, but, you know, the season that was that came to a grinding halt because of the pandemic, the Gamecocks were dominant
they
that
were there.
Season. They were, and probably
they were more dominant that season than they were this year.
Exactly. And then last season, the heartbreak in the Final Four with that missed shot that could have won the game against Stanford. I mean, you look at the what ifs. This team easily could have won three national championships in a row.
At least. But you've got the two. You've got the pieces obviously coming back for a second in a row and third overall. So when you play at a high level, there's going to be high-level disappointment sometimes, but there's obviously going to be some high-level joy, and that's what we're seeing right here.
So how long does this high last for the Gamecocks? When is it back to business for Dawn Staley?
Well, I mean, they'll start summer conditioning pretty soon, I think. But I think everywhere Dawn goes, you know, she'll be making appearances at various games. The buzz will still be there.
Right.
But I would think probably around August, when the other sport cranks up, when people start turning their attention to college football. You know, there'll still be the buzz, but obviously you'll have other diversions. But, you know, she'll make an appearance, I would assume, at one of the football games as a celebrity starter. Or maybe at the spring game, if they have like a trick play, if you have a celebrity participant. You remember a couple years ago, Steve Spurrier dropped the pass, whatnot. But you've had Debo. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if Dawn or one of the players is involved in some capacity. And so, yeah, it's still going to be there. I mean, throughout the whole year, you'll be reminded throughout the course of the whole year through appearances that what this team accomplished.
Shane Beamer is a big Dawn Staley fan. It would not surprise me in the least if somehow, some way, Dawn Staley makes an appearance at that school.
By the way, Shane had a nice ceremonial first pitch last night at the softball game where the Gamecocks hosted Clemson. He had a nice strike there. So the pressure was on him. So it was good to see Shane. Obviously, it's not just football with Shane. Obviously, he understands that he's an ambassador. Dawn's an ambassador. Lamont Paris. Right. All these coaches are ambassadors, not just for their sport, but for the other sports as well.
I know in 2017, Coach Staley wore that netless, as she called it, right? Netless.
Yeah, I guess she's got two
now. It was the net. Mm-hmm. I know she's got the other. I can't see it on the shot today.
I haven't seen it. Maybe, you know, and she has it hanging up in her car as well. So, you know, maybe she's, I don't know.
We're just enjoying the images as you are at home as the players now. This is the
there they are.
Very back end of the parade. Yeah. And we expect this program to begin shortly at the State House. I'm wondering how many fans are on the lawn of the State House right now.
Well, because I mean, the ones that were on the back end took a while I don't know. I think overall, I mean, I'll be very curious if they get attendance figures. Who's that playing, JR? Do you know the band? Come on.
Queen.
Who's the lead singer?
Freddie Mercury.
Oh, very good.
1977.
Who's the lead guitarist?
That I don't know.
Brian May.
That I do not know. I do not know. But they are the champions. We are the champions, my friend, and that music should be playing right now.
Why not?
Let's just take a listen for a moment. A huge crowd on the lawn of the State House right now on the north side of the State House as this ceremony is about to get underway.
So Athletics Director Ray Tanner, Interim President Dr. Harris Pastides, who might, I mean, he gets to celebrate another national championship. he came back, so it worked out well for him.
It sure did, and we'll be hearing from Pastides coming up shortly in the program.
And obviously, Athletics Director Ray Tanner, you know, we've seen him win a couple of national championships as the head baseball coach. He's been to four, actually. So he understands this feeling of not getting it and then obviously winning back-to-back. So obviously he can appreciate what this team has accomplished from coach to coach.
Yeah. The weather has certainly cooperated. Great weather right now for this ceremony. Right now about 80, 81 degrees outside with some overcast skies. Not real hot, not a cold day.
It's been perfect. Yep.
Just perfect weather. Again, as this all unfolds, we're looking at it live just as you are. And right now we're looking at the size of that crowd. It is incredible out there.
And that's just part of the view. I mean, obviously there's people, obviously a big crowd behind our camera that we're looking at now. So again, when the attendance figures, if they can track such a thing, I mean, I would guess 18,000 at least.
It's going to be in the thousands, obviously. I'm not sure exactly how many have showed up. We'll wait for some sort of estimate from the Columbia Police Department.
We'll see how close I am. See if I went over. But if I come within 100, I get both showcases.
Is that it?
I think that's it.
Usually ask 250. But
oh, times have changed.
If you say so.
When Bob was in charge, it was $100, I think.
Yeah. All right. And we mentioned just a few moments ago, we do have live team coverage continuing. Kaylin is standing by with more in the middle of all of this. Kaylin, what's going on?
Oh my goodness, JR. There were thousands of people down all stretched throughout Main Street. It has been such an exciting day for fans out here. And while they gather around at the State House, many stopping at local restaurants, heading up to the front. Miss Tracy has been so patient with us. She's going to chat with us. Tracy, you said that you are a diehard Gamecock fan. Tell us what made you feel like you needed to come out here versus watching it on TV versus being at home.
Well, I feel like we need to support our team. Dawn Staley is an amazing coach. I mean, she's probably number one in the industry. And just support our girls. You know, we're from South Carolina, so we need to be here to support them. It's just easy just to say you're a fan, but you need to come out and show your support.
Yeah, and tell us just how it felt to be so close to her. I mean, she was right there. You could have touched her. I can only imagine.
No. Oh, it's just good seeing all the players. I mean, it's so exciting. Just being here is just so exciting. This is just second time, and we're going for a third.
Thank you so much, Tracy. I'm going to let her get back so she can actually see the team over at the State House. But, guys, just so much excitement. The excitement has traveled from Laurel all the way to Lady Street and up to the State House. A great day for South Carolina, a great day for USC, and certainly a lot of excitement for fans here and at home.
All right, Kaylin, thank you so very much. It's the Athletics Director Ray Tanner up there with some of the players right now as we're waiting the program to begin. The host of the program is going to be the play-by-play voice.
Brad Muller does a great job calling the action for Gamecock women's basketball. And he does other sports as well over there for the athletics department.
All right, we mentioned a moment ago that there's probably going to be a couple of months here where things kind of settle down. Everybody takes a breath. The season starts again coming up in the fall, November, is that correct? So how soon before Dawn Staley gets the USC women back into the gym to start preparing for that new year?
Today.
Really?
I would assume they may have taken a couple of days off, but I would think at some point they're right back into it. You can't, you know, because if you're not working, you know the other teams are. You know, UConn's in the gym. You know, Stanford's in the gym. Here we go.
This girl is on fire.
Obviously, some of the players having a good time with that song that's playing right now.
And I think we're about to start the podium. There's Brad Muller, the play-by-play voice of Gamecock Women's Hoops, about to get things started.
You should see what it looks like from up here. Thank you everyone for being here. My name is Brad Muller, proud to be the voice of your Gamecocks for the last 15 years. This never gets old, does it? In case you've forgotten how we got here, it's been a couple of weeks. These young ladies went 14-0 against ranked teams this year. At some point this year, they beat all the other teams that were number one seeds in the NCAA tournament. And all of the teams that were in this year's Final Four. And they beat one of those teams twice. Of course, they were SEC champions. Now they're national champions. Obviously, it wasn't easy. Everybody gave them their best game every night. But number one, wire to wire. That's how they started, that's how they finished, and that's why we're here. Thank all of you fans for supporting this team throughout the year and over the years. And thank you to all our Gamecock women's basketball alumni. A lot of them are down here. Thank you. To get things rolling at this time, please welcome to the stage the City of Columbia Mayor, the Honorable Daniel J. Rickenman.
Gamecock Nation! All right, we can't start if we don't start with a chant. So this side, game. That side, Cox. Game! Cox! Cox! Always wanted to do that, so I had to do it. Man, what a great day. Thank y'all for coming out to celebrate the women, I mean, look what they've done. What an incredible accomplishment. You heard 35 games. They broke 9 records. You know, we had Aaliyah with the double-doubles and the rebounds, breaking records. Come on! This is an incredible time, but, you know, at the city, we wanted to celebrate. And Coach Staley, could you come up here for a minute?
Yeah, Coach.
Hey, 2-time National Coach of the Year! So we decided to celebrate in the city of Columbia, and we wanted to make sure that we proclaimed, you know, on April 3rd, they won this little thing called the National Championship. And we talked about it, and we said, well, you know, why should we just declare one day National Championship Day? So we just decided to declare the whole damn month, y'all. So I have here the proclamation by the whole city council, and I wanted to give this one to Coach Staley so she can hang it in her office with the key to the city, which will get her out of parking tickets. But it's my great honor. Thank you and all the women in this basketball team, the band, the cheerleaders, the guys in the support. Y'all, hey, it's a team effort, and it was all of y'all. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And now, fams, please welcome U.S. Congressman James Clyburn.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. Coach, don't go far. I want to do a couple of things here. In a few weeks, you all are going to be visiting your nation's capital, and you will be received at the White House by the President of the United States. I'm going to leave the date up to you all to work out. He made the commitment that he'll do it, and y'all can decide when you want to come. Be sure not to schedule it on a day when Congress is not in session. Please do it when I'm going to be there. But in the meantime, I want to present you with a couple of things, Coach. Now, the coach is one of my road dogs. We hang out together. Now, I want to give you this certificate and this flag. On the day of April 6th, in celebration of this victory, this flag flew over the Capitol, and I want you to have it. Now, one of the things I try to do in order to make accomplishments real memorable is to not only congratulate you in person, as I've done, but I can put in the congressional record on April 7th, this is the record of the proceedings of the United States Congress on April 7th. And in this record, where this little yellow tab is, each one of you get a copy. You will see a tribute to the Gamecocks with your names throughout it. So for the rest of your lives. And each one of you will get a copy of the record to hang on your walls. Now, what I usually do during an election year, I usually put my picture right next to it. I'm not going to do that. But congratulations. Not only did you win a national title, you won the hearts of the entire country. And you ought to be congratulated. So, each one of you gets your own copy. This is yours. That's yours. Each one.
The University of South Carolina is so fortunate to have great leadership at the top. So at this time, please welcome your university president and Gamecock superfan, Dr. Harris Pastides.
Are there any Gamecocks at the State House tonight? Let me start by recognizing the back-to-back two-time national champions, the Carolina girls. Ladies and gentlemen, what a ride it has been. How many of you were here for the early NCAA round in Columbia? How many were at the regionals in Greensboro, North Carolina? And how many of you, like me, went up to chilly Minneapolis? I felt something happening to me. I told Patricia as we went out there to play Louisville, I said, "We have a date with Destiny." And she said, "Destiny Henderson or Destiny Littleton?" I said, no, it's not that kind of date. It's a date that has been written, that has been predicted early in the season. It was a team that, although they had the lowest average offensive scoring of recent NCAA women's champions, they also held their opponents to the lowest score in modern history. I want to tell you, though, Congressman Clyburn said it right. These young women won the hearts and minds of people throughout America. They were and are America's team. I want to tell you, Dawn Staley, what an amazing person. She has done more for gender equity, for equality in women's athletics than anybody in modern history. And it's the dawn of a new destiny, isn't it? I know she's going to say this, but I'll say it first. The fams, not the fans, but the fams. If you're a fam, raise your hand right now. And I'd like us to coin something new. There's another SEC team in football that claim they have a 12th man, and that would be the fans. But we, all of us together, male, female, whatever you go by. We are the sixth woman, all of us. In closing, I want to remind everybody that this is, I don't care what the newspapers say, this is the third national championship. We were in Dallas in 2017 when we beat Mississippi State, but I'll tell you, in 2020, we had only one loss all season. We were 16-0 in the SEC, and we were going to be crowned the national champions. And there are some teammates out there who came back to say hello today. We love you. We cherish you. That was the consensus national championship. This is the third one. We're going to keep going. How about we, Mayor, how about we keep this parade route, because we're going to need it again next year. So it's been the honor of my life to come back and serve one more time. We're going away on June 30th, but I could tell you, as soon as women's basketball season starts, we might not have the expensive seats, but we're never leaving this team. So go Gamecocks. Let's get the party started.
Always a tough act to follow, but fortunately, our next guest knows a little something about winning national championships. Your athletics director, Ray Tanner.
Thank you for allowing me to follow Congressman Clyburn and President Pastides. What a treat. 2017, in Dallas, Texas, they asked me where I wanted to sit, and I said I want to sit close to the court so I can be on TV. I sat right behind Asia Wilson's father. I got plenty of TV time. I haven't had that much since. In Minneapolis, they said, you're not going to be on TV like you were in 17. But what a wonderful celebration it is tonight to have so many people on this parade route. We didn't want it to end. Matter of fact, we might get back out and go back around again. But I want to tell you, it's an understatement to say how talented these women are at playing basketball. It's an understatement. It's an understatement to talk about our coaching staff and our support staff that work so hard every day in women's basketball. Give them a round of applause. And a vastly, tremendously understatement to talk about the greatest of all time in Dawn Staley. We all believed that we would be here. We had the confidence, we had the expectation, but it still takes a team. And a team is together, everyone accomplishes more. And that is the fans that have been recognized. We appreciate you very much. You make it almost impossible to lose at Colonial Life Arena. Thank you so much. I want to share one more number with you. Since we left Dallas in 2017, this program, under Coach Staley's direction, has 178 wins. How about that? 74 of those wins are in Southeastern Conference play. If you want to do the math, that means we win 86% of every single game that we play. I never heard of that. And as Dr. Pastides said, ain't no stopping us now. We'll be back. Thank you.
Stop right now, Carolina. Starts the season. I'ma show you how to make it all work. Another planet is a short term goal for me. The record's old for me, it's just more of me. You're here, for you to hear Kendrick persevere. Defenses I feel relentless. Ambition with a clear vision. Taking off, I ain't taking off this distance. The enemy, your distance came across me. How much it cost me to get you out my business. I said a planet is a short term goal. Sky is the limit, I'm past that, now past that.
Columbia, South Carolina is becoming title town.
I see myself performing now. Sold out shows where the room is packed. Sitting at the Grammys where the five awards. See myself on big billboards. I'm not a world of endorsement deals. Can't imagine how it feels. That's why I'm smiling every day. Because my dream ain't far away.
I'm so high, I can't touch the sky. I know it's my time.
You want to meet him? Let's welcome home your South Carolina Gamecocks. Please welcome to the stage your women's basketball support and coaching staff, assistant coach Fred Schmiel, assistant coach Jolette Law, associate head coach Lisa Boyer, and now your Gamecock student athletes. A freshman forward from Ellenwood, Georgia, number 20, Sanaya Fagan. A freshman guard from Dayton, Ohio, number 23, Breezy Hall. A freshman guard from Atlanta, number 25, Raven Johnson. A freshman guard from Wilmington, North Carolina, number 44, Sanaya Rivers. A sophomore guard from Baltimore, Maryland, number 2, Anaya Russell. A sophomore center from Brazil, Camila Cardozo. A junior guard from Lexington, South Carolina, number 0, Olivia Thompson. A junior guard from Toledo, Ohio, number 1, Zaya Cook. A junior forward from St. Thomas in the U.S. Virgin Islands, number 4, Aaliyah Boston. A junior guard from Rock Island, Illinois, number 12, Bree Beal. A junior forward from Mississauga, Ontario, Canada, number 15, Leticia Amihir. Now, I know she's not here, but let's make her hear us from Indiana. A senior guard from Fort Myers, Florida, number 3, Destiny Henderson. A senior forward from Rome, Georgia, number 5, Victoria Saxton. A senior guard from San Diego, California, number 11, Destiny Littleton. A senior forward from Charleston, South Carolina, number 32, Alyssa Weselick. And a graduate student from Durham, North Carolina, number 24, Lily Grisette. And finally, your 2022 Gamecock women's basketball head coach, Dawn Staley. And now let's hear from a pretty special young lady, a fantastic student athlete, and an even better person, the SEC and consensus National and Defensive Player of the Year, Aaliyah Boston.
Hey guys. I just want to say thank you all for coming out. We couldn't have had a great season without you guys. We hear you guys every single night. We step on the floor to play a game, and I just want to say thank you. Go Cox!
And now the person who has built this program to what it is today, a Hall of Famer as a player, and let's face it, she's going to be a Hall of Famer as a coach, right? Your SEC and National Coach of the Year, Dawn Staley.
First of all, I know when we get together like this, you know, everybody wants to hear something that's so profound. Right? Here's the most profound thing I have to say. That is, the victory was won before it was played. So often that people that are in the position of our team, being the number one team in the country, being the number one team in the country at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end, so often you don't finish the job. And we couldn't finish the job without having the complete support from the very top. You know, our president, President Pastides, our interim president, President Emeritus, hopefully I'm not saying that. I gotta practice that name a little bit, but I'll have it by July the 1st. our mayor, our council, women and men, our General Assembly, every single person that is of prestige really backed our program. They did, and we felt it from the very top, all the way down to, you know, anybody that's walking these streets of Columbia, South Carolina, to ride down Main Street and to interact with you all, our fams, and they hear you, like they hear you scream from the bottom of your hearts how much you love us, really resonates with me. It touches me. It touches me beyond, like, I'm a Philly girl and I don't really get emotional, but you make me emotional. And I really appreciate it. It's worth everything that we had to go through. I know we made it look easy, but it really wasn't easy. The sacrifice of all of our players all season long was apparent to us, but probably not to you all. So I want to thank our players for the sacrifice. At the beginning of the season, we asked all of our players, all of our coaches, all of our highlighters, that's our male practice squad. Yeah. The highlighters. We asked them to make this year special. And when we said make it special, they didn't really understand what that meant. They didn't. But it meant that some people will play a big role as far as getting out there and play, and some of them will play a bigger role because it's a bigger role not to play. So the people that didn't play a whole lot, you know, your role was a lot bigger than you thought it was, because you didn't have to accept it, and you could have blown it up, and we could have not been in this position right here. So I thank you for that. And then lastly, I want to thank you are our fams. Like, seriously, our fams. No one, like, they can make up statistics and say we were the lowest scoring team in NCAA tournament history. They can say that. Okay? They could say that we held our opponents to the lowest points, you know, in the history of the NCAA tournament. Okay? Here's what they can't say, that we don't have the best fans in the country. So when you're calculating stats, take that in consideration. So before I go though, here's how special our fans are. These are pretty cool. There are two people on our team that really didn't get a whole lot of notoriety, but our fans thought that they should be honored today. Those two players are Victoria Saxton. Come on up here, V. And don't ever mistake her name. Her name is Bree. Bree Bill. Big Body Benz. The fans wanted us to recognize you because so often you give us so much of you, and yet you're not often recognized in the public's eye. So on the biggest day of our season, which is the day in the share, this moment with our fams, they wanted to say thank you for your contributions to our national championship. So I said that was the last thing. Here's the very last thing. Here's the very last thing. Let's run it back.
Champions, nobody can take that from us, y'all. It's over. It's a wrap.
and gentlemen, thank you again for your support of these great young ladies. And what do you say we do this again this time next year?
And that is going to conclude the program at the State House. They're doing the alma mater right now, but you know, this program, about 30 minutes long, and we heard some good things from a lot of people out there.
You get it in, you get it out. you don't want to keep people there all night, but very succinct. So kudos to everybody, because the message was delivered. This team's going to be here for a while.
All right, and as you heard, the team has been invited to the White House. Representative Jim Clyburn saying for them to schedule that visit when Congress is in session, because he wants to be there.
Yep.
All right. So again, this celebration is wrapping up, but we're going to check in with Whitney Sullivan before we put a bow on things tonight. Whitney, what did you think of the celebration?
You know what, JR and Reggie, I have to say that this parade, the ceremony at the State House, this whole celebration was worthy of that of national champs. And it was just so beautiful to see everybody come together to honor this incredible team. And I know that the parade was for them, but I also feel like the parade was for the city as well, for those fams that Don Staley talked about, because they have played such a critical role in catapulting them into their success. Now, I have to say this, one of the most poignant statements that came from the State House ceremony was from Congressman Clyburn, who says, not only did you win a national championship, you won the hearts of the entire country. Now, y'all know me, I am a Tiger through and through. My loyalty lies with Clemson. But when people say, how do you feel about having to cover the Gamecock Parade and all the excitement around this? The answer for me is honored. I respect Don Staley and the team and what they have done, not just on the court, but off the court. I mean, you heard Dr. Pastides talk about that, how Coach Staley has really fought for equality for female coaches, for black coaches in the sports arena in general. And so I'm proud to be able to say that I covered an event like this. And you know, it's not just about winning, but it's also about how you win. And I think that the team has been such a great representation of South Carolina and our values. They have gone out to every single game and put forth 100%, but they've done it with class, they've done it with dignity, and they've done it in a way where they have honored everybody who has helped them get to this place. So again, y'all, it has been a beautiful day, an exciting day. And I have to say, as I'm looking out the street right now, people are clearing out from the State House. So if you're headed to downtown Columbia, I'd probably give it about 10, 15, maybe 20 minutes as things clear up. But again, it has been a beautiful day, celebrating a team that really deserves all the honor and all the respect. And if you talk to the team and the players, they'll say, we also want to give honor and respect to all the fans who have really cheered us on all the way to that national title. All right, we're going to send things back to you in the studio. I do have to say this, JR and Reggie, I'm not going to be this sentimental during football season, okay? It's Tigers all day over here when it comes to that.
I hear you, Whitney. Good job, Whitney. Thank you so much. A big thanks to all of our team members who are in downtown Main Street. We had 8 people downtown covering this event today, and we thank each and every one of them for their time. Of course, we have much more on the celebration on our website right now. Simply go to WLTX.com, and a complete wrap-up when you join us later tonight for News 19 at 11. Any final words from you?
Well done. Everybody down there. I mean, the city, everybody. Yeah, it was quite something to see.
All right. Well, thanks for tuning in. We'll see you again later this evening.
Thank you for watching News 19. Did you see a story you loved? Download WLTX on your Roku or Amazon Fire device and watch it again right now.